About a month and a half ago, we had this computer here where we upgraded the cooling system, and we actually built two computers inside of this massive case. So it's back for an upgrade. This time we're going to install an ROG Maximus Z790 Hero board with 64 gigs of DDR5 RAM and a 13900KF. Once we get the new hardware up and running, we'll compare results from the old 10900K and Z490 board. But first, let's unbox this Maximus Hero Z790 and go over some of the specs. As always, we'll be using a CPU frame with the 13900KF and this G-Skill DDR5 RAM, and we'll slap some CryoNaut Extreme in between the water block and the CPU. As usual, I really appreciate the way Asus packs things. It's almost like a piece of art. Inside, we have our ROG gaming card, a USB flash drive that can be used to install drivers and software, a ton of SATA cables, also a ton of M.2 standoffs, USB 2.0 splitters, front audio cable, Wi-Fi antenna, and some extra thermal pads for the M.2s. This is the ROG Hyper M.2 card. This allows you to add two extra M.2 components. One runs on PCI 5.0, the other PCI 4.0. On the back of the board, we have the BIOS flashback button, clear CMOS button, one HDMI port, four USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports, two Thunderbolt 4 USB Type-C ports, two USB 3.2 Gen 2 ports, Intel 2.5GB Ethernet port, four more USB 3.2 Gen 2 ports, and lastly we have all of our audio connections plus an optical output and the Wi-Fi 6E antenna connections. This is a big LED screen that displays ROG. Hopefully we can customize it, not sure yet. Then we have two shielded PCI 5.0 slots, cutout holes for both 1200 and 1700 cooler retention plates, 20+1 power stages with massive heat sinks, two CPU 8-pin connections, four fan headers, post header, start and flex key, 24-pin motherboard power, an extra 6-pin, this is to deliver more power to the PCI slots, USB 3.2 header, 6 SATA connections, another USB 3.2 header, then we have our power reset button pins, USB 2.0 headers, a bunch of fan headers, and RGB headers. Next, we unbox the CPU, remove the ILM, then install the CPU and the CPU frame. If you have any questions about this portion of the video, please ask below. I'm not going to get into all the details, but long story short, the ILM causes unnecessary deflection of the CPU. The CPU frame fixes the deflection, which in result, it decreases CPU operating temperatures. Last thing to go over are the three M.2 slots on board. As you can see, once you remove the cover, it exposes where they go. Always remember to remove the plastic film on the thermal pads prior to installation. It's also worth noting that the PCI slots have this like quick latch slider that has a button at the edge of the motherboard. No more using a screwdriver to hold down the button to remove a GPU. So we finish up by installing the motherboard, connecting everything, and we only installed one 3090 this time to improve thermals, and the customer is going to use the other 3090 on another computer. We were not able to figure out how to customize the graphics on the motherboard. However, after further investigation, I don't think it's possible. Maybe there's some third-party app, but we couldn't find anything, and if you do know a way, please let me know in the comments below. Regardless, this board looks sick. Up next, let's compare some data to see how much performance we gained out of the new combination. Let's start off with a Cyberpunk benchmark on the old setup with a 10900K, 64 gigs of DDR4 RAM, and the Asus Z490 Maximus Hero. The settings we're using on both tests are at 1440p, no ray tracing, but everything else is set to the highest setting possible. When we're done with the test, I'll come back and discuss in conclusion if I think the Z790 Asus Hero is worth the upgrade.
Encontrará sus bajas.
Now for our new combo. Just look at how much faster the 13900KF screams through the benchmark. The 10900K literally took over 30 seconds to complete one pass. Now, it's no secret or surprise, but it is interesting to see side by side how much faster the 13900KF really is. Now, for the 13900KF, we only scored a 38,496. I say only, but a lot of these score 40,000 right out of the box. Now, I messed around with the voltages and core settings as much as I wanted to and really couldn't get any major improvements. The most I got was a little over 39,000. Now, part of this could be the silicon lottery that we're dealing with. Some of the other chips may have just been better chips. Who knows, but either way, there's really no difference in performance between a 38 and a 40,000, especially since these benchmarks don't really test out how well a system performs in games. It's basically just a maximum, let's give it all it's got and see what happens. As for Cyberpunk, one thing to note is we went from PCI 3.0 to PCI 4.0. The results are still very noticeable and much smoother gameplay. For the Cinebench run, it's no secret the 13900KF was going to outperform it, but looking at it on the charts just goes to show how much faster the 13th gen is. Now to answer the question of the day. In my opinion, this motherboard is not a good value for its high price and many features that most users don't need. If you want the best of the best, the Asus Apex Z790 board is a better option. Although it lacks Thunderbolt connectivity, it is a little bit more favorable for overclocking, particularly for memory. However, keep in mind that 13th generation Intel chips and boards will soon be outdated with the release of the 14th generation chips and boards, as they're going to be using a different LGA 1851 socket. Despite this, the 13th generation chips are still highly competitive and more than enough for most software and games available today. Next week, we'll be unboxing and reviewing the Asus ROG Strix B650E ITX motherboard. I'll share all my likes and dislikes about this board. Also, we're planning to get our hands on a 7900X3D. And if successful, we'll test multiple GPUs and update our charts with the results. We anticipate and look forward to observing a significant improvement in gaming performance. Afterwards, we hope to have our hands back on the PNY 4090 that we had at RMA, and we'll resume testing this GPU out on multiple different configurations to compare the data. We hope these tests will assist some of our audience in making informed decisions about the hardware that best fits their needs. Last but not least, I want to remind our viewers about the upcoming PC giveaway. I'll include a link to last week's video where we showcase some upgrades and demonstrate its performance in various games. Also, I'll give a sneak peek of the computer at the end of this video. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.